Roberts as new Chief Justice of the Supreme Court on this and other issues remains to be seen. Reporting from Houston, I'm Katie Heim for Free Speech Radio News.
We don't have to go through this pain anymore. We're going to take it up, though. You don't have to do it no more.
The University of Alabama's first black graduate has died. Vivian Malone Jones was one of two students whose attempt to enter the school in 1963 led to then-Governor George Wallace's infamous stand in the schoolhouse door, his bid to keep them out in violation of federal orders. Once he stepped aside, Jones and James Hood walked in and enrolled. Jones graduated 2 years later. Vivian Jones had been admitted to an Atlanta hospital after suffering a stroke on Tuesday. She was 63 years old. Tomorrow on KPFA's morning show, just after the 7 a.m. news, John Dicker, author of The United States of Walmart. Mostly sunny tomorrow in the San Francisco Bay Area, except some areas of fog and low clouds near the ocean. Highs from the 60s near the coast to the lower 80s well inland in the central San Joaquin Valley tomorrow. Sunny with highs from 86 to 92 degrees. That's it for the news tonight on this Thursday, October 13th. Thanks for joining us. Thanks to your financial contributions, we were able to meet our goal tonight. Thanks to Tai Robinson and Grace Chow, who produced the recorded portions of this broadcast. Kelly O'Ramars is at the controls with Max Pringle. I'm Mark Miracle. Good evening.
National Radio Project, Producers of Making Contact, presents An Evening with Norman Solomon, author of War Made Easy, in conversation with KPFA's Against the Grain host, Sia Sung, on Sunday, October 16th, 7:30 p.m. at La Pena, 3105 Shattuck Avenue in Berkeley. We'll discuss the role of media in a time of war and during national disasters, followed by a musical performance by the relentless political folk singer, David Rovics. This is a benefit for National Radio Project and Hurricane Katrina Relief Organizations. Tickets will be $10 to $15. For more info, visit www.radioproject.org or call 510-251-1332, extension 102.
And you're listening to KPFA 94.1 FM, KPFB 89.3 FM in Berkeley, KFCF 88.1 KFCF in Fresno, and on the web at www.kpfa.org.
This week in the community calendar, KPFA Peace Awards 2005, Medicare Changes Meeting, Iraq, How Did We Get Into This Mess, and Where Do We Go From Here? Fruit Tastings. This is a listing of upcoming events in the Bay Area. Please listen closely for contact numbers. Please join us for the KPFA Peace Awards 2005, An Evening Respecting Peace, on Sunday, October 16th at 6 to 9 p.m. at the First Unitarian Church of Oakland, 685 14th Street, Oakland. Excellent food, poetry, and live music. For information, call Lem Lem Regio at 510-848-6767, extension 255, or email development@kpfa.org. Get informed on upcoming changes in Medicare at a meeting of the Contra Costa Gray Panthers with Diane Whaley of Health Insurance Counseling Advocacy Program, HICAP. Meeting is at 1:30 p.m. at the Concord Library, 2900 Salvio in Concord. Call 925-937-8321 for information. Middle East analyst Juan Cole will be speaking about Iraq. How did we get into this mess and where do we go from here? On Tuesday, October 18th at 7:30 p.m. at the First Presbyterian Church of Palo Alto, 1140 Cowper Street, Palo Alto. Wheelchair accessible, $5 to $15 donation. Call 650-326-8837 for information. The Berkeley Farmers Market, an ongoing benefit for the Ecology Center, hosts fall fruit tastings on Saturday, October 15th on Center Street between Martin Luther King and Milvia. This is a free event. For information, call 510-548-3333. The community calendar.
Good evening. This is Maya on Apex Express. Excuse us for the technical difficulties. It is fun drive time here, and yes, it's our favorite time of the year. We got a great show for you today. We got a feature on Beckie Masaki, the executive director of Asian Women's Shelter, who is receiving a big, huge award from the Women of Color Resource Center later on this month, the Sisters of Fire Award. We'll be talking to her about the domestic violence work she does in the API community. We'll also be featuring the CD, which is also a giveaway for today, called Creating Seeds of Change. It's a multicultural compilation representing 60 years of resistance against the nuclear bomb. And also, we have another CD for giveaway. It's called Asian Crisis. It's a collective of artists here based at the Oakland Asian Cultural Center. They've got a lot of beautiful music representing jazz and a whole range of the API sound. So we're going to get into this first track by Asian Crisis. It's called Stolen Fields. And we're going to line that, up here in the CD track. And we just want you to feel free to call us. It's fun drive time. And let us know how you feel. This is the time that you can come and support Apex Express and KPFA by calling 1-800-HEY-KPFA. And just let us know how you're feeling. And, you know, this is a public radio station, and we need your support to keep this show alive. This is an Asian Pacific Islander radio program, one of the few in the nation to reflect your community. So here we go with Asian Crisis, track number 5, which is called Stolen Fields. Enjoy.
Oh,
with Beckie Masaki, the co-founder of Asian Women's Shelter. Thank you for joining us today, Beckie.
Thank you so much for having me.
So tell me a little bit about the Asian Women's Shelter and how it began.
Sure. Well, my involvement is as one of the co-founders. I started work in domestic violence field over 20 years ago at another battered women's shelter, and I was the first and only Asian person that worked there, and no Asian people came to that shelter. And there was a pervasive myth within the domestic violence field, I think, that, oh, Asians don't need this kind of service, or if they do have problems around domestic violence, they stick to their own, or they wouldn't come out and use services. But I personally knew that so many people in our community were in violent relationships and needed a safe place to go. And so that was my drive to be one of the co-founders of Asian Women's Shelter. I didn't do it alone. It was really thanks to a group of women. There was about 10 of us that worked together slowly year by year before we were able to fulfill our dream. And then we were actually able to rent a house and start the shelter in 1988.
So it's a direct service shelter. And can you tell us about the services of Asian Women's Shelter and why it's important in the API community?
Yeah, I think that two things are special about us is definitely we are about direct services, but we're also about community building. And what we mean by community building is organizing and working to change the cultural values and the kinds of things, the systems, the kinds of things that keep women in violent relationships and limit their access to resources and ways for all of us in the community to live violent-free lives. So that's one aspect of our work that's full of community organizing, education, coalition building, connecting to the bigger global picture of ending violence against women. And then the other side of our work is direct services. So day by day, we have a 24-hour hotline. We have a shelter where women and children can escape from violent relationships, and they live there, and they can be safe, and we work closely with them side by side as they rebuild their lives.
What do you feel are the top issues, like the top three issues in working on domestic violence in the API community? What are the challenges that makes it so important to make culturally specific services for the communities you work with?
I think that the top three things I would say is, one, that domestic violence crosses all lines, so we know it happens in every segment of our community. It happens to every population. But our services and our systems have not crossed all lines because of racism, anti-immigrant sentiment, lack of language access, and cultural sensitivity and competence. Because of all those things, they've created additional barriers for Asian women and other more marginalized communities to be able to access services. So that's why there's a need for language and cultural specific services like Asian Women's Shelter. But also that we see ourselves as part of a bigger picture that includes all populations. So we want to participate in making violence against women non-existent for everybody, not just our Asian communities, but for all communities.
Speaking of the bigger picture, how do you feel the state of the world that it's in right now, how is that affecting violence against women in the API community today?
I think that the state of the world is really impacting the situation of violence against women in lots of ways. First of all, there's so much violence in the world, and we promote violence through war, through street violence, through family violence, through the media. There's so many messages that say violence is okay, and it's okay to dominate or, you know, be over, use violence to control others. So where are we getting the messages that that's not okay? Where are we teaching our children or letting women know that they don't deserve it and that there's nonviolent solutions to conflict or to living? So that is, I feel, really a challenge in these times when violence is all around us, to be keep giving the message that violence is not okay. But that's what we feel that our mission is to really promote peace. The other thing I think that's challenging is because so many resources are going towards violent solutions, like the war, that leaves less resources for community-based programs such as ours or other alternatives and solutions that don't include violence or the criminal justice system. So I really feel like if we could make a shift and focus our resources as a nation and as a world more towards community-based solutions and nonviolent ways of resolving conflict, we'd be a lot farther in ending violence against women.
What was the biggest triumph you feel that you've seen through your work, and what kind of changes have you seen come about from that?
I think I would think of three big milestones. Is one, just even opening the doors, because that in itself defied the myth. You know, when people were saying, oh, this isn't a problem in the Asian community, once we opened our doors, the first day we had our first family, and we continue to have a flow of women and children who need a safe place to escape violence. And we're turning away people because there's so many that need our safe shelter. So that in itself, I think, defies the myth that it doesn't exist. And it has been really important for hundreds of women and children to have a safe place to go. So that, to me, has been an amazing victory. The other thing is the courage of the women and the children who've come through our program and have actually been able to go on to rebuild their lives without violence. That's incredible. They've made these major transformations in their lives, and they've been able to sustain that. It takes a lot of courage and a lot of strength. And so that, I think, has been amazing. One example of that is, in particular, is that undocumented women were a lot of times batters were using immigration status as a means of threat and to control the women in their relationships. And so we were getting, in the early 90s, women who thought they were being sponsored for U.S. citizenship by their U.S. citizen partners, but those partners had lied or withdrawn the petition or done other things to keep those women's immigration status under their control. And so those women stood up. They told their stories. We were able to work with other organizations like the Family Violence Prevention Fund and the National Network on Violence Against Immigrant Women to bring those stories to Washington, D.C. And that was what enabled the immigrant provisions to the Violence Against Women Act in the mid-90s. So for the first time, women who were in that situation were able to self-petition or to explain that they were in domestic violence relationships and then be able to go on to get their citizenship.
So tell me about the API Institute on Domestic Violence that you also helped co-found.
Actually, it's the first and only national organization that is focused on API and domestic violence. And what happened is when Asian Women's Shelter started, we were the third of just three in the nation that could meet the language and cultural needs of Asian women experiencing domestic violence. And through the years, many other programs grew so that now there's, I think, close to 80 different grassroots programs throughout the nation that are by and for API women to address this issue of domestic violence. So as we grew, we realized we needed a national voice. And so Asian Women's Shelter was just one of several organizations that band together to start the API Institute on Domestic Violence. And there's an institute on domestic violence in the African-American community, and there's one in the Latino community called Alianza. There's also efforts in the Indian country, in the Native programs. Like, there's a program called Mending the Sacred Hoop, and those are for tribal people who are addressing the issue of domestic violence. So in each of these communities that previously had not had services that reached their communities, these national institutes are really able to put a focus on our particular needs and bring a collective voice to the national arena.
What are the steps that you would like to let people know they can do to be active about supporting that person?
What battered women often say is that they wish somebody would have said, "You don't deserve it." And to some of us that haven't been in a domestic violence relationship, we might think, well, of course, that's obvious. Nobody deserves to be beaten. But if you're in a relationship where you're getting put down and humiliated and threatened in physical, sexual, economic, verbal ways, you really need to hear that message. You know, you don't deserve this. So I would say, if you're somebody that knows a sister or a friend in the situation, that's really important to let them know. And the other thing to let them know is that they're not alone. A lot of the dynamic around domestic violence is isolation, and people feel a lot of shame, and they feel like, I'm the only one with this problem, and it's my fault, and I have to keep it a secret. And that's not true. That, unfortunately, you're not alone, but fortunately also you're not alone, that there's many people who believe you and who want to help and who have also experienced the same kind of situation as you. So I would say, you know, really reach out to people, and also feel free to give them our hotline number. We have a toll-free number, 1-877-751-0880. And just let them know that they don't deserve it, that they should reach out for help.
And what are other websites that people can learn more about domestic violence in the API community?
Well, we have a website at Asian Women's Shelter. It's www.sfaws.org. It's SFAWS, as in San Francisco Asian Women's Shelter. But ours is a very basic website. We hope to improve our website. That's one of our tech goals in the next year. But an excellent resource and excellent website is the API Institute on Domestic Violence. And I don't have the address memorized, but the best way to do is just do a search on API Institute on Domestic Violence, and you'll be able to find that website. And it's a great resource for national information. We've also, you know, helped to contribute to a lot of collective information, like innovative strategies on domestic violence, particular to the Asian community, cultural competence curriculum from Dr. Sujata Warrior, who's from New York. There's just like a ton of resources on that website, so I'd encourage you to go there.
Well, thank you so much for speaking with us today on Apex Express, and we congratulate you once again on your Sisters of Fire Award from the Women's of Color Resource Center later on this month. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Women's of Color Resource Center. Apex Express. This is 94.1 KPFA. And that was the voice of Beckie Masaki, the executive director of Asian Women's Shelter, who is winning a huge award later this month, along with Angela Davis, Suher Hamad, and Teresa Meja. This is recognizing women who are breaking new ground from the Women of Color Resource Center. And today we have a whole bunch of folks in the studio tonight. We got Lawton on the board and Will, who's going to help us pitch for a while. And also a couple friends, Kai and Amy, who's going to maybe give us a little feedback on why they support KPFA. The reason, you know, we do this every year is because this is a public radio station ran for and by the people. And what you can do today is to call 510-848-5732, or if you're listening from outside the area, call 1-800-439-5732. That's 1-800-HEY-KPFA. We're given two CDs today, Seeds of Change and Asian Crisis, which you heard a track of earlier. So the reason why I'm just going to talk from the heart right now. This is a grassroots radio show, and we got technical difficulties sometimes, but we're really working hard to represent the communities that we serve. I mean, when you walk through the doors of KPFA, you can see the community that is here dedicated to, you know, one of the few democratic things that works in this nation. I mean, we don't have a perfect country. We got so much stuff going on, but this is one of the things that works and one of the things that we can keep trying to make work. And you could see that when you walk through these doors. You could see it when you're listening to the programs. You could see it when you have volunteers coming in just answering the phones. And, you know, you can just pick up the phone and let your voice be heard. Call 510-848-5732 and 1-800-439-5732. You can donate anything you have right now. We got, you know, you could donate like $60 and get this beautiful CD, Asian Crisis. It's got all kinds of jazz and a compilation of different sounds in the API community. And we also have Seeds of Change, which is representing 60 years of resistance against the nuclear bomb. And it's part documentary, part funk, part soul and rock and all that. And, you know, I'm just going to pass it on to Lawton right now to let us know how you feel. You've been around for a while, right, Lawton?
Yeah, that's right. I've been here for, well, I guess I've been at the station for like almost 2 years now. It's been a while.
How's that been for you?
It's been interesting. Yeah, it's been very interesting so far. So, yeah, I just want to give out the numbers again. The phone number is 510-848-5732. To support KPFA, and also 1-800-439-5732, right, 1-800-HEY-KPFA.
What's up with you, Will? You've been around forever, it feels like.
If I've been around forever, then some of our listeners have been around. We won't go there, but we want you to go to your phones right now. 800-439-5732, 1-800-439-5732, or 510-848-5732. Let's talk about Apex Express. Let's talk about this block of programming you have here. It started, if I'm not mistaken, I'm not the true historian here, but it was the One World block. And you've got, we've got one person on the phone.
Yes,
at 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. Why don't you join that person? It started as a one world block where you've got Africa Today, you've got La Raza Chronicles, you've got Voices of the Middle East, Apex Express here on Thursdays, and Full Circle on Fridays, which is, you know, supported by the apprenticeship program. We're talking about independent voices. We're talking about stories from different perspectives that you didn't hear here at Pacifica Radio back when it started, even though these communities represent the communities that our mission was built upon. Our mission was built upon being here for what people like to call the voice of the voiceless. I don't think it's about, you know, communities that don't have a voice. We have voices. It's just our voices weren't being heard. And we're here now. And we're bringing you stories. We're bringing you important issues to the air. And if you want to support that, we need you to go to your phones right now. 510 848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. You can call in and say you support APEX. Maybe you support Democracy Now. Maybe you support the music programming that's coming up after this show at 8 p.m. with Bonnie Simmons and with Dirk Richardson. Whatever you support, just call in right now and show that you support Free Speech Radio. Again, the premium is Asian Crisis. For $60 pledge, that could be broken down into $5 a month for the year. Hey, that's, you know, less than the price of one of those nice lattes people get on a daily basis. 1-800-439-5732 or 510-848-5732.
Right, and today we are going to play Seeds of Change, which is Creating Seeds of Change. This is a compilation against nuclear bombing, and what we got today is a little collage for you to listen to for a little bit, and it is featuring Mr. Keihiro Matsushima, who's an atomic bomb survivor and part of the Hiroshima World Peace Mission, and he's going to be speaking from his first-hand experience from surviving the atomic bomb. And we're going to play this right now just as a sample of what you can get if you call in right now, 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. This is Seeds of Change, and we're going to play that track right now.
The ground zero, the temperature is said to be 4,000 degrees Celsius for 1 or 2 seconds. People must have been broiled or barbecued in the street outdoor. I just felt hot, and I jumped under the desk, covering with my ears and eyes. And that time, huge noise followed. Hundreds and hundreds of thunders at the same time, and I just crawled along the floor, and when I touched my head, my whole body was bleeding from head to feet, shirts broken, and trousers torn. I was scared to death, of course, and I just prayed, Buddha, help me. On August the 6th, that morning, we were already at school. But that day, my classroom was on the upstairs, second floor of two-story buildings. And there were almost 70 boys in that classroom. I was seated at the extreme front row at the corner. And beside me, there was a big window. The window facing to southward to the sea. It was very beautiful summer day, as you know, and 15 minutes after class started, at 8:15, I happened to see out of the window, and I happened to see two American bombers, B-29, flying very, very high in the air, and they were shining in the morning sun, very beautifully. But we were careless about those planes because the sky of Japan had already been occupied by U.S. Air Forces already. They were flying almost any time, almost free, because we didn't have any normal planes to counterattack them, and that doesn't make any sense. So they were flying totally almost any time. And when I look back to my textbook, that was the moment of explosion. Dazzling strong flash and huge shock wave and hot heat wave attacked me all the same time. And the whole world changed into the sunset world.
Keihiro Matsushima, who is speaking from his first-hand experience as an atomic bomb survivor. And this is a compilation, Creating Seeds of Change, and you can get that here for the premium of $50 for calling 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. And this CD is great. It's representing many parts of the globe coming together to end nuclear bombs and focusing on Livermore Nuclear Weapons Lab, here, which is here in the San Francisco area. And that part you'll listen to in the next segment. But right now, I really just want to talk about my personal commitment to here to Apex Express. You know, we're representing the Asian Pacific Islander community. And when you think about that community, that is a global community. And that is hard to cover and truly represent the whole range of experience, the whole range of sound and art and issues. You know, there's so much going on in the world right now affecting the Asian Pacific Islander community. And we need your support so that we can continually cover those parts of our community and really put it at the forefront. We've got this segment or this show here from 7 to 8 on a weekday, and that's a really amazing place to be. And, you know, we've got an Asian Pacific Islander hip-hop radio show on the second Thursdays of the month, and we've also expanded to bring a live show out of that to really bring the community together and be active about supporting the arts and hip-hop sound and the conscious community around KPFA. So please call 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732 and give us your support. I mean, anything you have. I don't have much, but I'm going to give what I have in my pocket today just so I can really just know that I was being active about creating a community that and creating a radio show and creating a radio station that really represents the people and is run by the people. So give us a call, 510-848-5732 and 1-800-439-5732. Thank you to all those callers who've called earlier. And we're going to go into the next segment of the Seeds of Change and hear a little more from the from Kehiro Matsushima and also some other folks that are on this CD. So Lawton's gonna line that up, and here we go.
You went out to the Livermore Nuclear Weapons Lab and took a tour of this facility, one of the primary facilities for the design and development of nuclear weapons. And I think you're one of the first, if only Hibakusha, to have the courage.
Oh, was I?
Yes. So how was that experience for you?
Well, at first I was surprised that a very huge land and beautiful land is occupied by such a lot of facilities related nuclear power. And when I think of that horrible day 60 years ago, I just can't stop tear when I remember those victims who were killed in a brutal way, you know. And I had a very complex feeling. In a sense, I was a little sad, you know, and I just hoped the result or things you are doing here should be used for peaceful purpose in the future. I just hoped so. All the people, all the mankind should cooperate for the future of the world. And I want to say, never repeat the same mistake again. Hiroshima and Nagasaki were enough. We learned a lot. The third A-bomb must never be used on any nation, on any people in the world.
The weapons of mass destruction are here at Livermore, created in Berkeley. We got to find a way to make the UC system, the institutions of higher learning and knowledge, to be used for the betterment of people, not to build nuclear holocaust.
Oh,
listening to Apex Express 94.1 KPFA. Give us a call right now and give us your support, 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. We're listening to Creating Seeds of Change, this compilation. That track was Universal Language Revolution. And there's so many people on this, actually, this album. Well,
yeah, I mean,
call it out.
Well, you are listening to Universal Language. It's a, as it says on the CD cover here, it's a musical melting pot fusing traditional Latin music with grooves from all parts of the globe. And they've got roots here in Cali. They're also from Mexico, Israel, Italy. We also heard before that a collage from Mr. Kihiro Matsushima, and he's an atomic bomb survivor, and he's a part of the Hiroshima World Peace Mission. And there, I mean, the CD is about peace, just like this station here is a beacon of peace. And if you support that, 510-848-5732 is the number to call, or 1-800-439-5732.
And in our short time, we can't really play all the tracks, but we, just to name a few, we've got Spearhead on this this CD, and we got Azatlan Underground, Cesar Cruz, who is also involved at KPFA, La Brava, Mumia Abu Jamal, all speaking against the nuclear bombs and bombing in general, violence in general, and also, here you go. Just like, I just want to hand it over to you. 510-848-5732. Give us a call, 1-800-439-5732.
Aslan Underground, Company of Prophets, Spearhead. These are artists you hear here on KPFA on Hard Knock Radio, on, you know, here on Friday nights on La Onda Bajita. Cesar Cruz, again, a programmer, La Brava, part of La Onda Bajita.
Thank you for the call.
You can have these artists right now, like the caller that just called right now, at 1-800-439-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. And this premium, Creating Seeds of Change with all these different artists, is available for $60. Right now you're hearing track 9 of a CD called Asian Crisis, and the track's called...
It is called Dita Gaonan Mindanao Mix, which has a traditional Kulintang song of the Philippines. And this is another example of Apex Express, all the different sounds you're going to hear here at this show, Apex Express. And we've got a couple supporters here in the studio with us today, and we just want to, you know, represent you all, the listeners, and hear from them firsthand why they support Apex Express and KPFA. And their name is Kai and Amy. Just want to let us hear your voice right now on the mics.
Hello.
Hello.
So why are you here, and why are you here supporting Apex Express and KPFA?
Well, I support Apex Express because I have to. It's one of the very few platforms we have for our voices, our stories, our issues. Even in a place like the Bay Area, where there's so many Asian Pacific Islanders, I just feel that it's radio stations like this that help us become visible. You know, these are the stories that we need to say to learn about each other. We have so much to learn about our community and about ourselves, and, you know, shows like Apex make that happen.
And just call 510-848-5732 if you want to join in with Kai and support Apex Express and KPFA, 1-800-439-5732. Thanks for the caller right now. And Amy, why are you here supporting KPFA and a continual listener of KPFA here?
Well, I want to touch back on what Kai said. There's so many APIs in the Bay Area, and I myself have just recently moved to the Bay Area from a place where we didn't have anything like KPFA and shows like Apex Express. And I am really proud to support a station and also a show that continually gives us, like, the pulse of what's going on, not only in the API community, but other communities, communities of color that often don't have the spaces like radio or just public media to have a voice and representation. So I support KPFA. I support public radio that really advocates for the truth. And that's what KPFA is to me.
Thank you so much. That's the truth. That is the truth. And if you believe in the truth, because that's what we try to bring here. Give us a call at 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. We need those phones to light up. And
that's the truth. We need the phones to light up.
Okay.
Okay. Give us a call right now. 510-848-5732. We need to, you know, the truth is ever expanding. We need to cover the truth, and we need to, you know, let us hear from you and let us hear your support, because for a growing radio station, for a growing people-supported, people-sponsored, and this is one of the very few gems in the country that is staying free of corporate ownership and privatization. You know, what can you say really is out there that is not free of that? This is one of the very few growing and healthy seeds within our community that we really need your support to keep going. I mean, I'm not like trying to preach right now, but this is really it. I mean, we're not trying to profit off of the money that you give. This is money to pay for the bills, pay for this equipment, pay for these studios to stay alive,
pay for the power, pay for our telephones.
Right?
I mean, and we're going to give you something back. We've got a $60 pledge premium of the music you hear behind us, the Asian Crisis CD, if you call 1-800-439-5732. $100 gets you both CDs we're offering this hour. The Creating Seeds of Change compilation that's got all our friends on it. Come on, you're just bringing your friends home. Again, we got Spearhead, La Brava, Cesar Cruz, Aslan Underground, Company of Prophets. They're all speaking truth. They're all bringing you the music. Utah Phillips, I mean, that's for our Sunday crowd. You know, we play Utah Phillips too. We do it all here. So 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. The Creating Seeds of Change CD is available for a $50 pledge. The Asian Crisis CD is available for a $60 pledge. Both CDs are available for $100. We need to see, as our friend says at 5 o'clock, those lights of hope. Those lights of hope need to light up right now. Beacons of Truth, we need you to call right now, 1-800-439-5732. If you support a democratic radio station, which is what we are here at KPFA, you own us. And if you want a piece right now, if you want to continue to show that you support us, to pay our bills, the money that you put into this station goes back into the community, because all we do here is put community issues to the air, and we debate them. We're not about censorship. We're not about an agenda. We're all about letting everyone sit here at the table and partake. So if you'd like to do so, give us a call at 1-800-439-5732, 510-848-5732.
And this is Apex Express once again every Thursday 7 to 8, and thank you for your support. We'd like to continue and play the next track here, and if you can, Lawton, if you could forward it to the next track, and we'll just give you something nice to go out on. This is actually from Monument to Masses and their new CD that's out. This is just one example of the many sounds that you hear here on API Radio Apex Express. And it's this CD that's playing right now. We're just going to go on to the next track here. And thank you for your support.
510-848-5732, 1-800-439-5732.
Comes from silence. It's music.
is Apex Express, KPFA 94.1. Thank you for the callers that have called in at 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. We'd just like to take the time to thank our callers, Brian Agula, who is out calling from San Jose. Thank you for your pledge this evening. We are so grateful. And Don Franco and Lynn Hamilton out of Occidental.
North Bay. Thank you.
For your support. We really, really appreciate it. That's the kind of stuff we'd like to hear, and that's the way that you support this radio station.
510-848-5732. In our last 2 minutes here in our KPFA fun drive, we need you to go to the phones to say that you support free speech radio, that you support the cutting edge programming that Apex Express brings you. It's very multifaceted here. It's not just about the music that we bring you here on Apex Express. It's about the different activists that come through and tell you their stories. It's about the community organizers and the nonprofit organizations holding community events that come through and talk about what's really going on in your community. 510-848-5732, if that's something that you support, if you want it to keep coming, because if we don't have your calls, we're just going to have to stop.
Exactly.
So,
it's about the working class people. It's about people with having hella jobs and just trying to pay the bills. That's what we represent.
We're here.
We have hella jobs, and we're trying to keep this radio show alive.
Tell it.
You know, like, we're not even getting paid for this. These people are here up until, like, the morning, late at night. There's people here at every hour just trying to give you something fresh and give you something that really represents the truth and really represents who you are as a listener, and what do you stand for, and what do we stand for. You know, this is, just give us a call. There's still time, and it's 510-848-5732. We got Bonnie up next, who brings beautiful music of all kinds, just to continue supporting, and call us at 510-848-5732
or 800-439-5732. 510-848-5732. It doesn't matter which one you call. Again, Bonnie Simmons and Dirk Richardson coming up next, and we need you to
Thank
go to your phones
right
now.
Oh,
there's a caller right there.
510-848-5732.
Thanks to the crew, Lawton on the controls.
Thank you, Lawton on the board, and our guests, Kai and Amy. We'll hear more from them in the future in Apex. And Will, thank you for coming through and blessing the mic and giving us the context and the history of Apex and how it came about on KPFA and all the dynamic programs here in KPFA. Give us a call, 848-5732 or 1-800.